Al-Ali, the one who's the all high. Can anyone be above Allah when he's the all high? هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن. He's the first and the last and the highest and the nearest. If you look at more than 9-10 translations of the Quran, when they come to this verse, they say he is the first and the last. And some of them say, they say Omega and the Alpha, I think they say Alpha. Or Alpha and the Omega. What Alpha and Omega, yaakhi? Just say first and last. Easy to translate, yaakhi. First and the last. Awwalu wal akhiru. But they want to use big words, confuse you. He's the Alpha and the Omega. Say the first and the last. Huwa al-awwalu wal-akhiru. Wal-zahiru. The messenger asked him, explained it already. He said, وَهُوَ الظَّاهِرُ لَيْسَ فَوْقَهُ شَيْءٍ. He is the Zahir, there is no one above him, meaning that he's the highest. Simple. If you take the tafsir of Rasulullah, you will understand the meaning. And he is the batin, لَيْسَ دُونَهُ شَيْءٍ. And he is the batin, there is no one nearer to you than him. Means he's the nearest. That's why if you take the noble Quran of Taqiyuddin al-Hilali and Muhsin Khan, may Allah reward them, Taqiyuddin al-Hilali rahimahullah, a scholar of the Arabic language and the deen of Allah, he combined together with Dr. Muhsin Khan, and they translated the noble Quran. When they came to this verse, so far they're the only ones I found that they translated it correctly. Out of about 10 different translations of Quran. All the others, they say, he is the outer and the inner. A'udhu billah. How could Allah be inside creation? Inside creation. The outer and the inner. Because they took the literal translation. Without understanding the hadith. Without going back to the hadith of Rasulullah. So they go astray. And wallahi, one of them in the footnotes, he said, the arsh is not real arsh. It's not a throne. Don't, you know, say even throne. It's not that. You're trying to think of anything to negate it. Subhanallah. And they think they are modern day translators of the Quran. Confusing the people. And how many confusions we have about that? About the translation of the Quran. We have individuals like the Qadianis. When they say, Sirat al-Ladina an'amta alayhim, Qadiani, this Ghulam Ahmed, what does he say? Who claims to be a prophet after the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He says, this verse refers to me. That you should all follow the path of those who Allah has favored. Allah favored me, so you should all follow me. Since when and who said? You see how they misguide the people? SubhanAllah.